referees for this one, Ryan Jones, Duran Few and Mikey Graham. And there'll be some feeling in this. The Tuatara have the advantage from the first matchup, plus 12. They won that 88-76. And remember, if we have ties, head-to-head counts. But only if it's a tie between two. If we have multiple teams, more than three or more, then we go across multiple series. But the Tuatara do have the edge over the Bulls. Sal's NBL action underway. And Iuli, a little lucky to steal the tip, if you like. Rob Lowe sets the screen. Rosetto with a big job to do on Lowe with the fadeaway. No good. And rebound for Denham Brooks. So Corey Webster with a chance to bring the ball down the floor. Looking to get into their first offensive set here. Leon Henry. They are loaded with players that can shoot the three. Webster drives the lane, gets feet in the paint, scrambles, gets the rebound. Giddy pots for three, no good. And the Tuatara, Russo Nance, threads the pass through. Rob Lowe, great vision from Russo Nance.
Amazing pass, great look for the big man down the court.
Incredible to think that Dante Russo Nance is still a teenager. I need to go and double check the date of birth. I'm pretty sure that he's still 17.
Doing pretty well being in this league, isn't he?
Oh, quite remarkable. Webster looking to get an open look at a three around a couple of screens. Henry, 1 second on the shot clock. Henry pulls up. It's good. Triple from Leon Henry. Good composure.
Great awareness of the shot clock as well.
Barrow for Schneider. Low. Rosetto had to get a hand up quickly. Iuli. And Giddy Potts with the long rebound. Either of these teams, they do have the ability as Potts drives reverse. Rob Lowe was always going to be tough to finish around. They both have the ability to light it up from deep. And so Russo Nance pulls up. That's well within his range.
Just looked like a really nice controlled shot. He looked so comfortable right in his zone.
He is a scorer. Henry feeling it, not on that occasion.
I like the no hesitation, just take the shot right up.
Oh, rejected by Brook. Tuatara maintain possession. And they're just going to check with the score bench here because there's a reset on the shot clock and there shouldn't be. So what are they going to go to as we look at our GJ Gardner replay? And have another look here. It's a Brook getting high to reject this one.
Incredible block.
Great athleticism. Schneider for Iuli. Low. Low to the basket. Morgan Maskell talked about having to shut down Rob Lowe. And that's the sort of spacing they can't afford to give him in the paint.
Not at all. But that screen was set so well. And it was good for the passer to find him on the roll.
Henry. Webster, Schneider, all over him like the proverbial cheek suit that Corey doesn't wear, by the way. Leon Henry, in and out, Rosetto strong on the boards. Cutting to the basket, going up without the basketball, tipped away. Possession will stay with the Bulls, 8 seconds on the shot clock.
The Bulls are doing a great job going to the offensive boards. Not sitting back and letting the ball come to them. Being super aggressive.
Early change as Iuli has replaced Chris McIntosh on the floor. Rosetto. Hand off here for Webster, who shoots it over two hands. Henry battling for the board. McIntosh comes away. Brook did well to get back on the hip of the guard. Rob Lowe is always hands up and ready to shoot the three. McIntosh. Barrow from the elbow. Nice, good patient basketball.
I was watching Barrow warm up and he loves that shot from the elbow. Good to see him knock it down.
Two hands on Webster though. That's a cheap foul given, although I think Barrow had a feeling Corey might have been on his way to the basket there, so perhaps deciding I won't give him two cheap ones. Tipped away by Schneider. Rob Lowe went to sleep a little. Leon Henry had an open look, and the Tuatara got away with it.
They're going to have to be careful leaving him open. He looks like he's looking for that three without hesitation.
Barrow underneath, got Henry up, and then missed the easy layup. Well, Nick Barrow, and then Corey Webster's... Well, I thought he played that off Nick Barrow. What's the ruling here? Referee's overturned it, so it is going to be Bulls possession.
It was a smart heads-up play by Webster. Saw the defense on his hip, threw it right at him, went right out of bounds.
Barrow made the room though, didn't he? Got the spacing, got Henry in the air, and then missed the layup off the glass. Webster cuts baseline. Too much on that one. Rousseau Nance, anyone want the rebound? Schneider grabs it. Win here for the Tuatara. We'll book them a place in the six. For the Bulls, they can inch closer. Schneider from a long way downtown. Wow. Silo Schneider finding his range early.
Such a pretty looking shot as well. There's no doubt in his mind that was going in.
And that's the confidence he's developed. When he first arrived, he was struggling to impact the game scoring and was very focused on dishing them out. Leon Henry all alone, my goodness me. You cannot leave the bed out there.
He will shoot the ball. They've got to get out on him.
Schneider tried to respond immediately, and Rob Lowe scrambles, can't keep it in. So Leon Henry is dominating proceedings for the Bulls with those two triples. Still, the Tuatara lead by five. Corey Webster. Brooke can also catch and shoot. Right across both these rosters, they have that ability. Lowe looking for the run of McIntosh. Giddy Potts doing the hard work to get back. So powerful, Giddy Potts. Brooke, Barrow, good defensive position. Giddy Potts with the triple. It's raining trees in Pukekohe.
Such a good shot.
Turnover by the Tuatara. So this has been a really good absorbing of the initial pressure by the Bulls, and they've come back big time, and they are scoring in multiples of three. It's as we would expect in this, nothing in it so far. And Leon Henry stepping up, looking like he wants to take control, like all good vets do in big games.
His three-pointer is looking really nice, and if they don't get up and pressure him, he's going to let it fly.
And he has been letting them fly. He's got the two made buckets on five attempts, Leon Henry. Tendenbrook, one of one. So these are all three-pointers for the Bulls, all of their made baskets. Got the fans talking about it already. And, for the Tuatara, they have one of three from deep through Silas Schneider, but the concern perhaps for Morgan Maskell was a couple of those early looks for Barrow and Rob Lowe getting 2 feet in the paint. They've got to do their work early, haven't they, and try and keep those bigs out of the paint.
Exactly.
Looks like Cale Robinson might be checking in here for the Bulls. Averages 16 minutes per game. He's going at just under 6 points per game, Robinson. And he's one of the best in the league in three-point shooting percentage, albeit a small sample size. He's going at 57% from downtown. That's 12 of 21 on the season. So he, too, can hurt you from long range. Here is Robinson. Brooke, pick and roll. Webster utilizes the space, tipped away off the basket and eventually in. That may well have been Beattie. Jet Thompson it was, I'm sorry. He got up there, perhaps to be credited for that. Schneider. Rob Lowe from the corner. Three ball on the way, no good. And kept in play superbly by Iuli McIntosh. And that's what he's on the floor to do. Find his spots, make the threes. Can't do so. And Tuatara, after leading early, just got stuck on 11. Robinson, tough finish. Off the iron, Rob Lowe comes away with it. Tuatara running. Schneider, a bit of work to get the separation. Offensive foul. It's looked like he may have raised that lead arm. Here's a look at the bucket at the other end. Tipped away by Lowe. And Denenbrook it was. Eventually I got there with who scored the bucket. Always a giveaway though, isn't it? So Kaysen, if you're the offensive player, if you lift that lead arm into another player, the referees are likely to call you, aren't they?
Yeah, any sort of extension, you're definitely going to get called for an offensive foul. If you can get away with it if you're subtle about it, but if it's obvious, there's no way you're going to get away with it.
McIntosh with the foul, reaching in on Corey Webster. So 14 on the shot clock. That was a no-look pass from Brook, and really Getty Potts wasn't in the right position to take it. Low. No foul given. Look like Corey Webster might have had a piece of McIntosh. Robinson. Brook running downhill, stolen by Iuli. Beattie, the youngster. Does he go upstairs? Well, he would have. Getty Potts was already up there and said, get back down there, fella, but foul is called.
I would not want to drive into that guy. No way.
He is strong. But, so we see the steal here, the pass, and Getty Potts, there's no way Beattie was making that basket. He'll have to earn them from the free throw line. Potts heads to the bench. And interesting, so too does Silas Schneider. So when one American import guard leaves the game, so too does the other. Might see that pattern throughout. Beattie no good with the first. Still stuck on this 11 points. And they're still there. Barrow can't get there. So Tuatara, someone's put the lid on the bucket for the moment. Webster. Exploring. Great pass, great patience. Rosetto, the big man with the big man finish.
That pressure on Webster is going to open up a lot of the players on the perimeter and down low.
So Nance, Fitzgerald on the floor for the Tuatara. Leon Henry with busy hands turned over. I can tell you that Aaron Young very close to calling timeout here. Turnovers, they've had missed looks at the bucket, they can't make free throws. I can tell you on the next to score, there will be a timeout called. And also Nance with the foul.
Kind of a cheap one there. He's trying to go for the little sneaky steal from behind, but got too much of his body on the with his arm.
Yeah, the only upside here is it's called on the floor, so no shots for Webster. He's on the dribble. Corey Webster will be hassled, and there he is. And Beattie takes the basketball away, and that's one way to make sure it goes through the twine.
They're really making Webster work on offense. He's not getting any easy looks, and he's having to create a lot for his teammates.
Rosetto, and there's Iuli this time with the hands. So they're very active. Braden Iuli over Robinson. Robinson stayed strong. Kick it out for Russo Nance. Second chance, no good. So low scoring quarter started with a hiss and a roar. Webster. Barrow with the hard show. Rosetto kicks it out. Henry has already made a couple, make it three.
Shooters will always shoot. If he's open, if he's got any daylight, he's going to take it. I love to see it.
you have got a ball handler like Corey Webster, as you say, Jason, as Risso Nance a little off balance. Barrow with the board. Beattie puts his shoulder into Brook. Iuli, what a cut to the basket. He's fouled on the way. Great movement by Braden Iuli.
For the Tuatara, it's going to be important that they keep crashing the offensive boards because the shots aren't falling at the moment, but keep getting those second and third chances. Buckets will fall.
G.J. Gardner replay. Iuli goes to the line. Important final 42 seconds here for the Tuatara. And they've just gone cold, about as cold as it is outside this gym. Temperature dropping this afternoon.
It's a little bit chilly in the gym as well. Should have worn a sweater.
So Schneider will sub in for the shooter. So the Tuatara with Risso Nance, Schneider, Beattie, Barrow and Lowe on the floor. High screen set by Rosetto. Webster jumps into the paint. Brook, and again that hand, it's risky, but he affects the steal that time. Risso Nance, Beattie, Schneider follows with the three, no good, and locks it up on the backboard. Game arrow goes the way of the Bulls. So shot clock will be off here. Chance for one final good look for the Bulls.
Russo Nance is doing a really good job putting the pressure on the point guard. Full court. It's really hard to do, bring the ball up the court when you've got defense on you the whole time.
Leon Henry. And eventually they will get it to Corey Webster, but he's dribbled that basketball back over the half court. Referee Ryan Jones right there in close attendance. So that's a cheap turnover and a chance now with 11 seconds for the Tuatara to just edge a little bit closer. So Jet Thompson and Chris Martin get out there. So Morgan Maskell putting a couple of the youngsters out on the floor and perhaps protecting his starters from a cheap foul or two here. Schneider drives. Barrow into the paint, makes the room. Nick Barrow, that's a great basket. And that's a prayer from a long way down the floor. Well, they started well, the Tuatara. They then got a little scratchy, but that bucket means they're just three down at the end of the first quarter.
I'm loving the confidence the Bulls are showing on the three-point line. When they're getting the ball inside, bigs are taking it up, but also they're going to start getting shut down, so look for the in and out, and another three-ball would be great. The Tuatara just needs to keep up their pressure. They're doing a really good job creating turnovers, just need to keep crashing the offensive boards, getting those second-chance looks.
And the Tuatara just 7 of 18 from the field, so their efficiency dropped away. Including 1 of 4 from the free throw line. You add that to the 7 of 18, and they are not making buckets like they should, but that will help. That is such a good looking shot. Wasn't dropping when he first arrived in New Zealand, but it is so efficient.
He's climatized now. He's ready to play. It's hard coming from the Midwest to New Zealand.
Not sure what you're saying about the Midwest, Casey. Corey Webster kicks it back out. Potts, Henry again. Is he on fire? No, that was the heat check. Rosetto with the board, puts it back.
Great offensive rebound there.
Schneider does go quickly down the floor. Barrow had position. The balls were very slow to rotate.
Just a good find by the big guy to the fellow big guy.
And it's back to a one-point ball game. Potts kicks it out. Leon Henry. Potts, that is so good. He is so strong. And the pass is superb. Schneider almost got too far under the basket. Couldn't make it. Webster, second in the league in assists at 7.3 a game, as well as second in the league in scoring, 27 a game. It's a pretty good combination. Potts, three ball on the way. Giddy Potts. Timeout is called to Atara. So just 1.5 minutes into the quarter. And Aaron Young does not like what he's seen. And that lead has extended out to 6. And they are just shooting on sight, the Bulls, aren't they?
It's amazing. It's amazing to see. However, you don't want to live and die by the three. You never know when you're going to get cold. So you got to keep moving the ball around. If you've got it, shoot it. If it's not falling, you've got to find something else. But it's falling now, so keep it up.
Just looking at the numbers so far. And the Bulls, the stats have updated just yet. I think 6 of 13 from long range. Now, if they can maintain that sort of efficiency, that obviously will be fantastic. But as you say, Kaysen, they're likely to drop into a little hole, aren't they? They're not going to continue to shoot the three at 40 to 50%, are they?
It's tough to do, but I would be amazed if they were able to do that. Leon Henry looks like he's going to try to break the record that Tiana Clark set the other day of 11 three-pointers made.
Wow, and what a performance that was.
It was incredible to see.
G.J. Gardner-Toihi really lighting that game alight and just putting her name around the country too in all the news media. So yes, confirmation they are 6 of 13 from 3. Compare that with the Tuatara, who are 1 of 8. So in that stat alone, the six-point deficit may not be that bad for the Tuatara.
Not at all.
Schneider. Just exploring, little two-on-two basketball. They kick it out for Iuli, and he shoots from the corner. And it's a good make from Iuli. He is going at 40% from three-point range this season.
Did you say 40%?
40%.
Wow.
Rosetto, big man, puts the shoulder into Rob Lowe, who stayed strong, and there's a foul as the basketball comes back down. Rob Lowe is talking about a raised elbow towards the jaw. It's the foul called on him. You can see there, still remonstrating with the officials. Oh, that's too easy. Oh, that is a coach killer. I just turned to look at Aaron Young, and he was shaking his head. A baseline play under the basket, and Giddy Potts all alone. Russo Nance with the three ball at the front of the iron. Henry brings it down. Oh, gee, that was almost stolen by Iuli. And now they've got numbers. Schneider there to intercept. And foul is called. Leon Henry stopping any momentum the Tuatara might have been gaining.
If I was Schneider, I would have just taken him right back up against Lowe, try to get him a second foul, a little cheap foul. But he was looking to be unselfish.
So Nance had the mismatch momentarily. Rob Lowe has Potts on him, so he'll look to take advantage of that. Gets to the bucket. Drops it in despite the attention of Rosetto. Three-point game. Oh, Webster. And then backs into Russo Nance. Oh, that is class. Off the glass. Barrow. Low with a little pick-and-roll action. Gets to the bucket. Foul is called. Rob Lowe, maybe 8 times out of 10 he's going to pop, isn't he, and try and shoot that three. So when he does roll to the bucket, it's sometimes a surprise.
When you've got a guy with a wingspan like that, when he's rolling to the basket, you just chuck it up and he's going to go get it. A few centimeters taller than the Bulls' big guy.
Free throw shooting for Rob Lowe, not at his usual deficiency. And that kind of makes my point. He's going at 59% this season. So I'm sure he'd love to just get up into the high 60s, perhaps, if and when they make the playoffs. Brook, whose space was shut down. Once the ball's out of Corey Webster's hands, the Tuatara are doing all they can to make sure it stays that way. Little fadeaway, Leon Henry off the front of the iron. Also Nance into the paint, causing trouble, draws a foul. That's two quick ones on Brook.
Musa Nance is really impressive for, what is he, a 17-year-old? High basketball IQ. He's quick on the floor. His defense is great. He's got the total package.
Yeah, he has a quiet air of confidence about him as well, which is great to see in a young player. But it's even better to see in your point guard, someone that's going to do a lot of the ball handling. Been 17 on the 20th of January, so he's a long way off 18. So
wow.
I did want to go and just confirm that.
He's definitely handling himself well around all these veterans.
Potts and also Nance with the board. Rosetto, Russo Nance goes through the big tall timber there, but can't affect the finish. Martin now for the Bulls. Rosetto and got good position, but Barrow straight up in defense. Diuli, he loves to drive to the basket. And this is going to go against Giddy Potts, who looked a little bemused by it all. And timeout is called by the Bulls. They want to have a chat about it. Braden Ayuli does get in the paint, does drive, and he asks questions of the officials. And Potts wasn't happy, but there was some contact.
Is that his second or third foul?
I think it'll be his second. He did sit very early. Brook has a couple, and that'll be the second on Potts. But at this stage of the season, these rotations will go pretty shallow, and you don't want players in foul trouble at all, do you, early on? You want to be able to let them play with the freedom and play big minutes.
Especially when you're a guy that's got such a strong presence just in his physical build as well as on the court. It's not someone you want sitting on the bench.
Well, Morgan Maskell spoke about it in the pre-game, that Giddy Potts has a job to do defensively on any of the Tuatara guards that might be in his vicinity. And when you've got guards that are so active, Russo Nance, Iuli, Schneider, they're so active, aren't they, that it's always going to put pressure on Potts. If he does get into foul trouble beyond the two that he's got now, that's a huge issue, isn't it, for the Bulls?
It's a massive issue.
We can call on Jet Thompson for some minutes to back up, and they'll have to. I can tell you that with the two fouls, Potts is sitting. I'm not sure they realize it yet, because the Bulls have got four on the floor, have they?
No. Oh no, they've got five.
They've got five. I just out of the corner of my eye, I did not see Martin out there. Low, it doesn't fall.
It was a great cut across the lane.
So Chris Martin on the floor with Henry, Robinson, Rosetto, and Corey Webster. Rob Lowe was one of two. His first visit makes the first. Aaron Young and his coaching staff looking on. Very impressive young coach, as is Morgan Maskell, the Sassels NBL, as Schneider gets in front of Webster. A little pressure high up the floor. A number of young coaches, I think, of Leighton Haddleton as well, taking over with the Sharks, with Rob Beveridge having been away. Some real coaching talents. All turned over. That's cheap from Henry. And Schneider through to the bucket and a foul to boot. So the two Bulls vets combined for a moment they'd rather forget here.
You've got to love his intensity on both sides of the floor. He's pestering Webster enough that he's got to give the ball up to the big, who then tries to find him again, turns it over because of Schneider. He's locked in offensively and defensively.
And one no good, so they are leaving a few points at the Razine. But so the Bulls with five team fouls, so every foul now, the Tuatara will go to the line, and there's 5 minutes left. Great defense, Russo Nance, but how strong is Martin? Rob Lowe steals it away, then the quarterback play for Schneider. Oh, this is showtime stuff from the Tuatara.
He's everywhere. He's so quick.
Martin was battling away in the paints. Robinson pulls up from the Razine. No good. And we're right in the midst now of a real swing for the Tuatara.
They need to keep this up. Keep up the pressure. Keep attacking.
Iuli, no good. Leon Henry. Webster finds some space. That's his spot. Corey Webster with the three ball. They needed that response, the Bulls. McIntosh gets it out for Lowe. Russo Nance. Webster did enough to put him off the three ball. Henry with the board. They want to get in the paint, the Tuatara. Rosetto. Oh, goodness. Sila Schneider. Oh. What's the call here? Offensive foul. Charge call. They're saying that Schneider had his feet planted and took the contact.
He's just involved in every single play.
Well, he certainly was there in plenty of time. Kaysen, I just wondered whether he had position. Here's the GJ Gardner Holmes replay.
He looked like he was set.
And so that replay not quite showing us whether feet were anywhere near or in no charge zone. But anyway, it's been called an offensive foul. And very, very close ball game. Just 1 point in it. We might have another look here with the GJ Gardner. He's outside the charge zone, isn't he?
Yep. He had his position.
Rosetto can't believe it. He's just had a chat with the officials, and fair play to Anzac Rosetto. He nods the head and accepts the word and heads to the bench. What's the change here? We're seeing momentum swings. We're seeing scoring runs. What's the change here? Is it just the energy levels of the guard line for the Tuatara that are making things happen?
Yeah, the pressure on the guards, it's not easy. It's tough work going from baseline to baseline, bringing the ball up the court on offense. Just constant pressure. And you saw when Webster had an ounce of light, no defense on him, he drained a three. But he hasn't been able to find that because they've been up in his grill the whole time. And I think that's what they're going to have to do, keep him occupied, put the pressure on the rest of the team.
Corey Webster, 2 of 6 so far, just 1 of 2 from long range. Mentioned early foul trouble with Brook and Potts for the Bulls, both picking up 2 personal fouls. For the Tuatara, they've stayed right away from the referees. Just 5 team fouls for them in the game so far. And nobody on the one. Barrow on the trail, rejected by Henry. Webster looking to run the play. Martin getting some minutes with Potts sitting. Webster looking to isolate, gets through. And the floater can't finish. Rob Lowe, look at them go again. They're off to the races. But Schneider, with that patience, he'll explore. Rob Lowe on the trail with the three ball. The Bulls dodged a bullet there. Robinson. Henry with the screen. Now Brooke comes up high. Webster says clear out of here. Step back. Henry with the three ball. He's made one from there. A couple though have come up short. Brooke just catch and shoots. And rebound Beattie. Schneider. Fox having to sit for the Bulls is making a huge difference in this game. Maybe that's part of it as well, that when he's off the floor, opportunities open up. Rosso Nance makes room. Robinson stayed in front of him, though.
It was a good drive to the basket, just didn't fall.
Henry. Denenbrook on the weak side, wasn't picked up.
It was a hard, hard show, almost a double off the screen, and that opened up the shot down low.
Rob Lowe's just stepped out of bounds.
You can see Corey Webster, he's just gasping for breath right now.
Fans young and old have done a great job in the Franklin community out here at Pukekohe. As Rosso Nance sits, he's a little angry. Webster now for the Bulls. Pass deflected. Rosetto kicks it out. Robinson can shoot the three. High arcing shot off the back of the iron this time. Schneider gets to his spot and shoots it over Leon Henry.
That dribble in pull up is just pure. He's so controlled, so balanced, and confident.
Up to 11 points now, the American. Martin. Robinson. Schneider is denying Corey Webster. Robinson with the turnaround. Tough shot, gets the roll.
That's what these Bulls are going to need, the other players to step up if Corey Webster's denied.
Yuli. Working around that on ball with Rob Lowe. Schneider shakes Corey Webster from his hip. Iuli for the three ball. It's good. And again, it's Schneider driving, kicking it out.
He's in every single play, offensive and defensive.
Nothing in it. One possession ball game. Rosetto. Barrow can't affect the stop. Rosetto gets his own rebound. Loses it. They kick it out. They've got time here. Shot clock down to 5. Webster creates space, as Corey Webster can do. The instruction from the bench, Aaron Young, look at him, top of picture, one shot. We've got about 3 seconds different, shot clock and game clock. All tied up here at the Stockyard. Yuli gets into action, drives to the bucket, can't get the roll, they get a rebound. Still time on the clock, they miss another layup. 4 seconds, time here for Webster. Look out from almost half court, can't make it, and we'll go to the break tied up here at 39 apiece. There is nothing in this. It's the battle of the 09, and the Bulls and the Tuatara cannot be separated here in Pukekohe. So much to play for as we race towards the 6 in the Sal's NBL. Stay with us when we come back. We will dissect this one by the numbers.
Thank you.
Their big win this afternoon over the Nuggets, and they booked their spot in the top six on the back of three superb imports, but imports that are bringing the best out of the local talent. You kind of have an experience of that in terms of being one of those imports coming into a league, but it's about that gelling, isn't it, on any roster to get the combination, get the role players, get everyone understanding their jobs, yeah?
Yeah, you've got to build that chemistry. If you don't have it, it's really hard to get in a rhythm, both offensively and defensively. But if you're welcoming, like when I was welcoming, everybody came welcoming me with open arms, so it was really easy to just blend in.
I don't know if we're allowed to talk about it, but you're not an import anymore, are you?
No, not. Actually, I got my residency a couple weeks ago.
Fantastic.
Yeah.
Fantastic. So the GJ Gardner Tauihi next season?
Hopefully. We'll see.
I'm really putting you on the spot here, aren't I? So,
hopefully.
You know, I mean, how good has that competition been?
I have loved every minute of it. I just wish there were more games in Auckland so I could go. But I'll have to settle for watching it on Sky.
Second half underway, and Potts is involved early, but Russo Nance does the defensive work. Russo Nance gets to the bucket and the foul. Is that a third on Potts? Oh, this is disaster for the Bulls.
That is not what they wanted. I don't even know if
goodness.
It was a hard foul or not.
Well, really, once Russo Nance had got that separation, Potts just had no business being anywhere near it. He's not happy talking with the officials. That is foul number three in the opening 23 seconds of the third quarter. And for the moment, Maskell leaves them on the floor.
You called it at the beginning. If they get him in foul trouble early, it's
turnover.
Not going to be good.
Russo Nance, look out. Potts is on him, and Potts just gets out of the way, and Denham Brooks says the ball's out of here. Oh, he did not give up on that play, Denham Brook. Giddy Potts had to.
He had no choice. He didn't want to pick up a fourth foul that quick.
Look for the Tuatara to see if they can play a little one-on-one against Potts. Iuli. Low. Schneider with the cut turned over, though. Pass was very difficult down at the ankles.
Not an easy catch at all when the ball's coming that low.
Webster. Schneider is in his grill like he has been all going. Hard show, Rob Lowe. Henry. Lowe gets back into the paint. Henry kicks it out. Brook from the corner. Rebound, Russo Nance. The energy of these Tuatara guards. Barrow from the regime makes it. Talk about role players. Nick Barrow is providing a perfect example of that here this afternoon. Henry from the corner, made three in the first half. And he's gone a little cold since.
The Tuatara are doing a really nice job rotating on defense.
Barrow for Lowe, all alone. Henry was late with the closeout. And Lowe, too much on it. Brook, Henry on the curl this time. Barrow had position, what's the call? And it's a blocking foul on Nick Barrow.
Great job by Henry, though. Shot's not falling from outside the three, so he took it right in, got the foul. Great job.
Yeah, that's a 3-point shooting percentage is slowly but surely dropping away. They're now 7 of 21, the Bulls. And early on, they were going at sort of mid-40%. And dropping away now down at 33. So Henry from the regime. Yeah, Leon Henry makes both. He's another one shooting the free throw from the regime a little less efficiently than he might at 58% on the season. Rob Lowe from the corner, it's good. Nothing but net for the big tall black center.
You don't want him to get hot.
Potts Oh, tapped away. Russo Nance almost losing it. Barrow, a little halfback pass. Schneider. Silas Schneider, one foot in the paint, and then comes up well short with the fadeaway. It's a big stop for the Bulls after the turnover. Leon Henry. Potts. Just a little step back, made some room. Iuli, again, the guards. They are rebounding like their place in the top six depends on it for the Tuatara.
Well, the Bulls only had one guy crashing the boards that time. They need a couple more. I know they're breaking back fast on offense, but they need a couple more offensive rebounders.
So Nance can't get the triple to drop. Schneider. A pretty easy call for the ref. Schneider saying Webster had the arm on the way through, but it was that first couple of steps from Webster that gave him the ascendancy there. Webster gets the elbow and then off the glass. Just has that shooter's ability to just hover in space and everything seems to slow down.
He's so talented. And if they're not bodying him, he's going to get those shots off.
Then they go to Lowe and offensive foul. So he's made some room in there, Rob Lowe, and done so illegally.
Bulls have a little bit of momentum now. Let's hope they capitalize on that.
Second personal on low. And their only other genuine big, Nick Barrow, also on two. So that's okay with 6.5 to play in the third. Potts here in possession. He sits on three personal fouls. Webster. Denham took the contact. Wow. And Rosetto puts it back. Back to a one-possession game. Long up high. McIntosh from the corner, catch and shoot. Potts. Also, Nance was sniffing around the tip one again. And Potts all the way, and then tries to dish it off. And offensive foul, that's four on Potts. No, I take it back. It's called, I thought it was on Potts. Rosetto on the trail is called for the foul. Oh.
That was close.
Did I have you a little nervous
you
there
had,
as well?
I was like, no, he surely didn't do anything.
Schneider. Oh, he is so efficient. The room was created by Barrow, and Schneider just drove the lane and an unguarded layup.
It's a little silent assassin. You wouldn't think he's as quick as he is, but he just moves around the court so well.
Webster, it's just been so often he has to look to assist. Great. And he does so. Great finish, albeit it was in a mismatch, but Rosetto was always too strong, too big for McIntosh.
Such a strong body. Every time he gets it in the paint, he needs to look to take it up. Try to get those bigs in foul trouble, especially Rob Lowe.
Vision as well from Webster.
Yeah.
And this is the adjustment that Corey Webster's making. And he's often double teamed and just completely shut down. He looks to his passing game. That's assist number five for Webster.
He just keeps his composure so well, especially when the bigs come up and double off that screen. He does so well to get out of it. Doesn't rush.
Schneider again, shut down that time. Barrow from the Razine. Oh, he's made that shot, and I think you spoke about it, Case, and you saw him in warm-ups. That's his spot, isn't it?
That's his sweet zone. He loves it. Thought for a second Schneider might lose that, lose the dribble, but he gathered the ball pretty well.
Webster for three. Always look good. Right in line with that one, Corey Webster. Sweet as. Turned over here, a little momentum and the crowd get into this. And It's a just an off-camera shot. Silas Schneider heads to the bench. I thought being subbed, but maybe he was aware of the timeout. It is an opportunity with 4:41 left in the third for both coaches now to have their say. But every time one team goes 4, 5, 6 clear, the other team finds a way to pull it back.
It's what you love to see. If you're going to come to the game, you don't want to see a blowout. You want to see the teams battle it out. Both teams are doing a really good job.
So Giddy Fox, I think Morgan Maskell's rolled the dice and just saying he's going to leave him out there. We've got a half-court shot here in the Sal's NBL. They have been made this season. Let's see how this young baller goes. Plenty of strength. Right up on the G.J. Gardner home sign on the backboard. And they've got a consolation prize courtesy of Sal's and G.J. Gardner Homes, but we have seen that shot made this season, and not just by these guys in playing uniforms. Some fans have had the chance to get out there and shoot for a little of their own glory. Corey Webster, 12 points on 5 of 11 shooting, 3 rebounds, 5 assists, 1 steal for Webster. Importantly, he's 2 of 4 from long range, and I think that's testament to the Tuatara, isn't it? They're just shutting down his shooting options.
They really are. They're doing a great job on the on-ball pressure.
Webster does step back, a little separation. It may have just been touched by Iuli.
Slightly off-balance shot.
Outlet pass. Oh, that is superb. Roblo running the lane. They can hurt you on the fast break like few other teams can. Giddy Potts had half an hour to think of that one. He said, all right, I'll make it.
In this game, you can't leave shooters open that long with that much space.
Russo Nance kicks it out for Barrow, just keeps it in. Rob Lowe, catch and shoot. Potts got a hand up in front of him. Oh, Beattie crashing the boards. The balls went to sleep. Low, Russo Nance, baseline, shot clock down to 4-3, long way beyond the arc. Iuli, good D here. Oh, the hustle low from the Tuatara. Iuli on the reverse, spectacular. The Bulls have got to stop these second chance opportunities though for the Tuatara.
And that's what we talked about at the beginning. If these Tuatara keep crashing the old boards, the shots are going to fall. They got second, third, fourth chance opportunity there. They capitalized on it. Got to find a body on the defensive end. When the shot goes up, you've got to box out.
Young Bulls bench are up and engaged in this one. The Tuatara starting to up the ante, asking questions defensively. Just 2 points in it. Webster into the paint. And again, Russo Nance with the rebound. And he drives it. Corey Webster, who locks him up, does well, the veteran guard. And Henry comes down with the board. Every trip down the floor, crucial. Leon Henry is now 3 of 11 from long range.
And I'm not sure who that foul's going to be on.
It's on Beattie.
Oh, yeah. He was kind of hugging him on the box out. Got to disguise it a little bit better. Put your butt into him. You can't go for the full bear hug.
To be fair, he was slightly mismatched, wasn't
just
he?
Just a little bit.
And all he could.
I appreciate the effort.
One of the great aspects of the Sales NBL is the young talents stepping up, and of course with the Tall Blacks away, and it shouldn't have been that case as Rosetto goes to the line. Of course, COVID delays. We've had this clash with the Asia Cup. Tall Blacks are away. Both these teams missing players. And it does open the door for some of the younger players to step up and grab their chance.
Let's hope they make the most of it.
Which Rosetto does not do from the regime. So they are leaving points out there, the Bulls. And they are not going for the regime that often. They need to capitalize when they do. Iuli step back for 3. Well, that was on the way down, but the officials must have decided that was below the rim when Leon Henry got there and tipped that away.
Yeah, I thought that might have been some goaltending.
Webster, Russo Nance with a hand up. Webster says, I'll shoot it anyway. Oh my goodness. The veteran says to the young buck, can't guard me.
Any sort of daylight he gets, he's going to pull it.
Schneider, Iuli. This is a tense, entertaining, and at times high-level game of basketball. Schneider kicks it back out. Russo Nance, can he return the favour on Webster? He says, hey, vet, I'm coming through here on the next generation.
He is not backing down. I love it.
Tuatara lead it by two. There's an offensive foul, illegal screen on Rosetto.
Potts is not enjoying these fouls being called on the Bulls.
DJ Gardner replay. We'll look at the Russo Nance triple. And they now have Rosetto on three fouls. So Potts and Rosetto for the Bulls. And Morgan Maskell having to go deeper into his rotations than he may have preferred. Russo Nance, Webster, great defense. Iuli on Brook. Has a speed advantage here. Does he look to try and get on his hip and go around him? Schneider, shot clock down to two, just got to put up a prayer. Doesn't get the iron. Gets a little backboard only. 24-second violation, great D. Big as this final minute of the third. Tuatara lead it by two. Oh, Webster thought about it. Oh, another steal, Russo Nance. Henry gets it back again. Contact. Who's this going to go against?
Henry, definitely.
Well, they're both 15. They're both 15, so that didn't help us. And who's it gone? I still don't know. Which way did they go with this? I think it's gone against Nick Barrow.
Really? I thought...
GJ Gardner replay. First, Webster lost it. Then Henry gets a hand in.
It was, looked a little bit even to me. They were both going for the ball.
Maybe a no call. Nick Barrow still chatting. He is a policeman. Jason, so
watch out.
I don't know how far does he want to go with this.
Make sure you don't speed out of here, he might pull you over.
He has to head to the bench though, and Leon Henry will head to the regime. So,
oh, so they did call it on him.
Yep. In a game that is as close as this, these calls become critical. And Leon Henry, after making those first three triples, they weren't all in a row. He did have a couple of misses. I think he was 3 of 5, but he's just gone cold. Makes the second.
I think it'll be huge for this Bulls offense if they can get him hot again. Whether it's driving into the lane and pulling up or taking it all the way, he's got to find a way to build up that confidence again.
Well, he won't stop shooting.
No, that's good.
All the experience in the world, he won't lose that confidence to shoot the ball. Beatty. Eventually with Schneider. Oh, Brook came out, had a look, and had to be called there. He just committed, didn't he?
Mm.
And as soon as Rob Lowe made sure the contact was seen. And that is now 3 on Denham Brook. So fouls are starting to become a factor. Both teams now in the penalty. Only 43 seconds left in the quarter. Rob Lowe drives past Henry, kicks it out. Beattie didn't fancy the three ball off the glass, doesn't go. Brook grabs the rebound.
That was a good take by Beattie to the basket. He had a nice soft touch, just didn't fall.
A little bit of difference here, shot clock and game clock. Torrey Webster, a rare moment, gets ahead of Russo Nance. That would have been huge from Leon Henry. Webster can't get the board. Iuli, 10 seconds. Russo Nance, they've got it with the right guy. 7, 6. Oh, great pass, great cut, great basket. And a foul.
Great no-look pass. Great job by the young guy to finish.
Oh, that is breathtaking with 3 seconds left. Chance now for the and one from the Razine. Yes, we have a look on the GJ Gardner replay. The free throw is good. And this is an absolute prayer. They've made it. What do the referees say? They are counting it. They are counting it. What a response. What a game. What an end to the quarter. 2 points in it. Auckland, the Tuatara lead the ball 61-59. Final quarter coming up. Total, he's now got six assists, 3 rebounds, and Webster with 15 points on 6 of 14 shooting, but this is in the balance. Jason Buckman alongside me, Andrew Jewis. Hope you're enjoying our coverage of the Sals NBL, proudly presented by GJ Gardner Homes. Who wins this and why in the final quarter? Who has to do what to win this game?
I think the Tuatara just need to keep up the defensive pressure. Don't allow Corey Webster to have any sort of space on offense. And for the Bulls, I think keep getting the ball inside. If it's not going, kick it out.
Certainly the three-point shooting has gone cold. Leon Henry after the first quarter was 3 of 6. He's now 3 of 12. Schneider gets to one of his spots off the iron. Rebound Henry, and noticeable there, the Bulls were crashing the boards. It might well be another message that's been sent by Morgan Maskell. Giddy Potts maybe can play with a little more freedom. 3 fouls, 1 quarter to play. Webster for Brook with the 3 ball, always looks short. Leon Henry got a hand in there, does enough. It's off Russo Nance.
I think the Bulls need to find a way to drive to the hole. They've only shot 7 free throws. They're not shooting the best percentage, but keep driving to the basket.
Yeah, 3 of 7 for the Bulls, 8 of 13 for the Tuatara. Potts, 3 ball on the way. Giddy Potts just hasn't found a rhythm. Had to sit through so much of that first half. Russo Nance, low, trying to roll to the hoop, but got all tangled up against Rosetto. Great defense. And Zach Rosetto, even better offense, Rob Lowe.
Just banked it from the corner. I don't know if you could do that shot on purpose, but he managed to pull it off.
Oh, and that one's thrown into the seats behind the court there by Leon Henry. Yeah, Nick Horvath, if you're watching, Nick, how's the physics on that? Can you bank one off the glass from behind the backboard?
I can't do it.
I'm guessing... I don't know, maybe there was a breeze in the gym.
Yeah, maybe. I felt like he was falling toward the baseline as well. I don't know how he did it.
It was brilliant by Lowe. Ioli from the corner, shooting the 3, turned one down earlier. Beattie, look at Schneider. He just has an ability to know where that rebound's going. Lowe for 3, this will be huge. Doesn't make it. Henry keeps it in. Webster on Schneider. Creates some space at the elbow, Corey Webster. And timeout is called. Aaron Young timeout as Corey Webster goes to work, creates his own space. The crowd love it. They're right on the edge of their seats. Why wouldn't you be?
He uses his body so well. But he's got to because they're all up on him.
GJ Gardner replay. Just drops the shoulder here, doesn't he?
Yep, boom. That's all he needs too. He doesn't need much space. Just give him a centimeter. He's going to knock that shot down.
Some of the giveaways, fan engagement here. And Blitz out there leading the charge.
Well, I don't know, who do you think?
Well, you know, sometimes you need the giveaway. Sometimes you need the entertainment to have fun at the basketball, and always you're guaranteed that. But this is one of those days where you could have shut all of that down here today and just have what's going on the hardwood, because this game is completely enthralling. I don't know which way it goes. I think for me, it's the foul situation could prove critical. If the Bulls lose one of their key players down the stretch, that could tip the balance. But you do sense that someone, a Lowe, a Schneider, a Webster, a Henry, someone is going to grab this game by the scruff of the neck.
Might come down to who can knock the most free throws down.
And both teams have had their challenges from the regime, not just tonight, but through the season. Lowe got into the paint. Strong finish through Rosetto. And maybe the foul count played a part there. Rosetto's on three.
But it's fourth quarter. Fourth quarter, you don't... You know, he's still got a lot of time, but there's still only 7 minutes left. You got to challenge him a little bit.
Webster gets to that same spot. This time too much on it. Iuli in the back of the Beattie rebound. They've had some great minutes, both teams, from young players. So Nance, low again on Rosetto. Kicks it out. Now Lowe gets into the paint. There's a whistle on the play. I'm not sure it's
I think it's on Potts.
Oh, it is.
It is on Potts.
Fourth personal for Giddy Potts.
Not sure what he was doing. Maybe just got in a tussle underneath.
Well, that's the one foul in the entire game he hasn't complained about.
Yeah.
So let's assume he did it.
Yeah. Safe bet.
So he sits. Be a case now of Morgan Maskell. How long does he leave Potts sitting off? Schneider gets around Leon Henry. Can't make the high teardrop shot. Webster low, tried to poke that away. Schneider with the foul reaches in. And the referee's going to call that every time, Kaysen. I mean, Schneider's saying that Webster's lifting the arm, but if you're caught hand in the honeypot, you're going to get whistled, aren't you?
If you're initiating the contact, you've got to expect a little bit of retaliation. He's got to protect the ball. So I'm not surprised.
Oh, Rob Lowe, look out, folks. Look out. Oh, he just quiet. Just quiet. Come on, Rob.
Just make sure it goes in.
Come on, Rob, with the build-up. Oh, and it's turned over.
This is not a good momentum switch.
Oh, wow. This is huge with 7 minutes to play. Rob Lowe with the steal. Gently placed it in the hoop. Here we go, Rob. This is the most gentle slam dunk you'll see in your life. And then the turnover. They lead by four, and now with another possession. Lowe goes to work again on Rosetto. Can't make it. But Rob Lowe looks to be the outlet for the Tuatara. They're going to the big tall wax center whenever they can. Off the foot. No need to reset. 16 on the shot clock.
Let's go, Leon. You got this, bro.
Leon's getting some encouragement from the fans behind us.
Webster. Robinson. Off the backboard. And Barrow tips it for Russo Nance. Separation now after a very close game could be crucial. Rob Lowe. Oh, Rob Lowe's coming to play. Rob Lowe, whether it's in the paint or from outside.
The veteran is doing it all for his team in the fourth quarter.
Early leader of the season MVP points, and he might be adding a few more to that tally. Webster for three. Doesn't go. It looked good. Suddenly, one of, if not the biggest lead, and that is another foul. It's on Brook. Is that four on Denham Brook? It is.
I feel like the Bulls are getting some, you know, ticky-tack fouls, unnecessary fouls. If someone's driving at you like that, the last thing you want to do is reach in. Get your hands back, let him run into you, and that way you're not initiating the contact.
Well, especially when you're on three.
Exactly.
They've got to be aware of that. But this is also, as the timeout is called here, this is also the pace, the constant, incessant pace of the Tuatara. And who are they blaming? Eh? They're putting the blame on someone. But the Tuatara have just kind of been wearing the Bulls down, haven't they?
They really have been. On the fast break, they're getting down the court really fast, courtesy of Siler Schneider. And then on defense, they're just relentless. Not giving them any any space. But when they do, the Bulls are capitalizing on it.
So this is now, with 6:11 to play, this is a significant lead. The Bulls' biggest lead was 6, and this is the biggest lead for the Tuatara, and therefore, by definition, the biggest lead in the game. The Bulls have had 8 points from turnovers, 28 points in the paint, second chance points, 12, fast break points, 5, bench points, 4. You know where I'm going with this. I'm going to give you the comparison. The Tuatara, 15 points from turnovers, 34 in the paint, second chance, 5, fast break, 14, 14 to 5. So there's a 9-point differential there. Bench points, 5.
Did you say on the fast break it was 15?
14
yeah.
To 5.
Well, they're getting all these steals courtesy of this guy at the foul line. I know a lot of players wish they were as quick as he is, because when he gets beat, he swipes from behind, generates a steal.
And he's had 4 and makes both free throws. So the biggest lead of the game is extended. 11 now for the Tuatara. They won the first clash between these two by 12. A win would put the Tuatara in the 6. It would give them 10 wins. The Bulls will live to fight again as Henry tries to refine the mojo. Can't do so. And now the clock is the friend of the Tuatara. Do they take the foot off the gas a little, do you think? Start running the 24 down?
I don't think they will. I think they're going to keep attacking.
Barrow, the handoff. Russo Nance just outside the regime. Barrow with the board. Barrow got the wrong side of Denham Brook, and then they turned it over. I don't think Barrow realized that Brook had no idea where he was.
No idea. I'd love to see the stats of the offensive rebounds, because I feel like the Tuatara are doing a really good job crushing the offensive boards.
I can help you there. They've got 10 offensive boards, but guess what? The Bulls have got 12.
Wow.
Just a little sneaky, isn't it? Offensive foul.
Another offensive foul.
Corey Webster's pushed off, and I think, judging by Corey's reaction, I think he knew that whistle was coming.
Was it Webster that fouled? Or was it the guy?
Who did they
call? Rosetto. Rosetto.
Oh, you're right.
Because I think he pushed his hip out on the screen.
4th personal on Rosetto.
Just enough. But, I mean, he's seeing the pressure they're putting on Webster. And he's trying to do whatever it takes to get him open, because you want him to shoot the ball. But that little, especially now in crunch time, don't want to get those ticky-tack fouls.
So, personal fouls, 4 for Rosetto, 4 for Brook, 4 for Potts.
Wow.
And they've got no choice here. Well, they've got to run with these guys. Rosetto takes a break for the moment, but Brook and Potts are on the floor. We're starting to approach that stage of the game where they must get stops and they must get baskets. Schneider. Picked off by Webster. Rob Lowe's taking a huge tumble here. And just the change of direction from Corey Webster caught his tall black teammate out there. And thankfully both are up and okay.
Webster's been holding his back and whinging a little bit. Been holding his back. I don't know if it's sore or what. From doing all this work up and down the court.
Well, he plays some minutes, Corey Webster. He leads the league 38 minutes a game.
I don't know if he's come out this game or not, has he?
4:51 to play. Corey has played 34-46.
So the whole game, pretty much.
Webster from the corner. And perhaps the energy levels are just draining a little. And you're right, as we see Corey Webster, just to keep an eye on him, folks. Jason Buckman's highlighted that is Schneider. All energy, all pace.
He's like the Energizer Bunny. He doesn't look tired. I've not seen him bent over once.
Potts. Brook with the screen. They kick it out. Robinson, they need to make these now. Can't do so. They get another look at it. Potts. Oh, it's passed behind Brook McIntosh.
It was the right read. He was cutting. It's a little bit tough on the pass.
The Yuli for three. This would be a dagger if it had landed. Still time here for the Bulls.
Yeah, plenty of time on the clock.
Henry backs in. Balancing act there. Potts drives into the paint. Potts met by Rob Lowe. Foul call. Giddy Potts with the heavy strapping and compressions on that right leg, and he's come up a little lame.
Probably glad a foul call went his way for once.
He now has to make this from the resine. The and one is vital. 3:42 to play. They can bring it back to 10. Just one possession by possession. Get back into the game. And that's where Potts doesn't have any issues. He's top 10 in the league. 87% from the resine.
Wow.
He's hurting, though.
Yeah, I wonder what happened.
Hurting the American.
He's going to power through.
Pain.
Yeah.
Schneider. Rosetto with the show. Schneider kicks it out. Iuli, there is the dagger. He didn't quite land it 30 seconds ago, but he does there. What a triple from the corner.
Great penetration by Schneider. Drew the help, created an open shot in the corner.
Potts from the resine. Battling for the rebound. Whistle on the
play. Oh, no. That's Potts.
Giddy Potts is out of here. Giddy Potts is fouled out. I tell you, Anzac Rosetto was going to take that. He was walking, thinking it was on him. They've called it on Giddy Potts. Fifth personal, and the American guard is out of the game. He doesn't want to leave, mind you.
Was he over the back, or did they just collide in the air? I don't know. I didn't see it. Is that a technical foul?
No, it's called on the floor.
Ref just pulled up a tee.
Aussie.
Teed the coach, I think.
So it's all unraveling here for the Franklin Bulls.
Somebody got a technical because Schneider's shooting with no players on the lane.
So the tech first. And we should then have free throws. The Tuatara in the bonus. So what was a close game, it seems, Jason, in the blink of an eye, is blown out here. The Tuatara have just been relentless.
All it takes is one play. And that foul and that technical, not what you want at this point in the game. I'd still like to see the foul, because I didn't think it was that obvious.
Potts does leave. The German heads to the dressing room.
So it was him that got the technical.
If he's told to get out of here, he was essentially already fouled out of the game, then gets a tech. Leon Henry still chatting with Ryan Jones. And Schneider makes all three from the resine, and this one you would think now is put to bed. And all the way through, it's been so close. But the Tuatara, this is an impressive performance.
Someone's throwing a soda can on the floor down in the corner.
Well, I'm amazed the referees are not stopping this. It's right near Leon Henry now, and under the buckets, Iuli comes away with possession, and they can get that can of drink off the floor. Schneider. I was about to say that for the Tuatara, they've struggled of late, so this will be a confidence-boosting win, and one that will. Oh, Schneider on the cut. Oh, doesn't make it. Everything about that was beautiful basketball, apart from the finish. Stolen. Schneider. Does he go alone? He has support. Iuli, they messed it up in the process. Iuli goes off the glass, gets the finish. And timeout is called. Morgan Maskell wants to try and stop the bleeding, but I think this is too late. May well be the Stockyard, but the Tuatara are dominant here now in this final quarter. Incredibly, this has blown out. 82-64. And they've possibly just run out of gas. They've been under some foul pressure. And they don't want anyone to have a look in the huddle. I'm not sure, Kaysen, that there's too much we can learn from this anyway at this stage. It's consolation minutes as we see the replay, the GJ Gardner replay. And Iuli on the fast break off another steal from Schneider. The Bulls, one of the biggest question marks here now is how they respond, not today, not tonight, but in their remaining three games. This is a bit of a blow for them, isn't it? With three still to play as they too chase a place in the six.
Do they have any more home games or are they all away?
2 minutes, 6 seconds, remaining this one. They will have a share. I'll just bring that up and find their run into the end of the season. But they're not done with here in Pukekohe. And for the Tuatara, they'll have one home game left against the Saints. And of course, the Saints on a roll, winning four in a row, got themselves in the six. Everyone, I would think, including the Ayers, the Giants at the top of the ladder, will be looking over their shoulders at the Saints. Bulls have the Ayers at home. Just been busy finding all the info as the Bulls make a bucket. The Bulls have got the Ayers at home on the 29th of July, and then they're on the road against the Sharks and the Nuggets, the Southern Road Derbies, or road trip, I should say, to finish their campaign. Rousseau Nance, Tuatara have done enough here, and they've been impressive. Schneider, that could cap it. Oh, my goodness me. How good, Silas Schneider.
He's been so pivotal for this Tuatara team, just creating, shooting, defensively getting stops, getting steals, and then another turnover.
So Nance for Rob Lowe. I'm not sure that Lowe expected it or wanted it, but maybe Rousseau Nance might go and finish it himself. Webster, a consolation three, front of the iron. Still scrambling the Tuatara for the rebounds.
Oh, I was hoping for another soft dunk. Settled for the layup.
They've really blown the score out. Schneider, 30 seconds left to play. Rousseau Nance from the corner. That would just be rubbing it in. Leon Henry and Aaron Young says let it play out. There is no need to. Oh my goodness. Rousseau Nance just picks the pocket of Denham Brook. And Rousseau Nance turns and lets him know all about it. The youngster with all the confidence in the world.
Had you not told me he was 17, I would have thought he was at least 20. The guy plays with so much confidence for a 17-year-old, a fresh 17-year-old as well.
This has been a statement performance by the Tuatara approaching the top six. And this will give them 10 wins, and they will bounce this one out. What a performance, what a final quarter, 89-68. Just an amazing final quarter. 28-9, the final quarter. And we will look to try and hear from a couple of key players in this one as Kaysen Buckman heads off to get ready to have a chat with a couple of the players. Rob Lowe has been huge. literally and figuratively his performance. We'll have a look at some of the numbers for you in a moment or two. As the handshakes. And this has been a dominant performance from the Tuatara in the Battle of the 09. Standing by to catch up with some of the players. Rob Lowe, high fives all round for the Tuatara. And Silas Schneider is standing by with Kaysen Buckman. I'm not sure that she can hear me, but I'll give her the
Siler, incredible performance tonight. How did you guys turn it around in the fourth quarter?
Just locked in on defense and then let that carry into our offense and get fast break points.
You guys seem to shut them down. You kept the intensity up throughout the whole game, but especially in the fourth quarter, how are you guys going to carry on? Now, you've got a spot in the top six now,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
So how do you carry on to finish out the